Once your mobile phase is filtered, attach it to the appropriate mobile phase tubing line. And make sure your tubing lines are flushed into a waste container so it does not carry any carryovers that can cause contamination to your system. The next step is to purge your HPLC. To purge your HPLC, you will use the purge valve by opening it, which will be turning it to the left. Now you'll see that the tubing will eliminate any bubbles that could be in the mobile phase tubing. Once there are no bubbles flowing through the mobile phase tubing, your purge process has been completed and you can close your purge valve now. Now we will talk about the selection of the column and attaching it to a Faro. This is called a Faro. For this setup, you will need a peak tubing, cutter, column, and Faro on each end. You'll take your peak tubing. To cut it appropriately, you insert it in the cutter. Instead of cutting it, you spin it. Now snap the peak tubing in the site it was cut at. This gives you a nice round shape that you can insert in the Faro. You take this end of the peak tubing, insert it in the Faro, just about an inch from this side. Take the Faro and you attach it to the column. To know which side you will attach this Faro to is by knowing the flow of the solution in the column. The column has a point indicator which way the solution flows. In this case, the solution is entered from the pump, from the HPLC, from this side. So you attach the Faro by tightly securing it on this end. Once the flow of solution comes in, then it comes out from this end of the Faro out to the detector for it to be analyzed. Now this column is ready to be installed in the HPLC system. Once your system is adequately primed, your column is in place, you have chosen the proper mobile phases, your system is ready to be equilibrated. When running your standards, you want to make sure you run your standards in multiple injections. That will ensure repeatability. There are many different types of HPLC systems. When operating one, important factors to keep in mind are selection of proper mobile phases, understanding the procedure in use so you can follow it accurately, and selection of proper instrument parts such as column. These will ensure a successful HPLC run. Thank you for watching.